everybody. It's Jennifer Ward from Down Dog Knox. Hope you're doing well today. As you can see, I'm sitting at my desk. I was doing a little bit of work. If you're like me, a yoga teacher, you sit at your desk with perfect posture all the time. So this is a really easy place to be. All right, I'm just kidding. So even us yoga teachers are human beings. So when we sit at our desk, oftentimes we'll sit and we slump. Or sometimes I put my feet up because I'm short and then I lean back. And then at the end of the day, I'm like, oh, I'm a little tired. We all know work can be stressful. So I wanted to bring you a few minutes here called Flex and Flow. And today in our Flex and Flow, we're gonna come into the upper back and the shoulders and see if we can get a little stress relief from our day. You can do this at any time during the day. You might try it in the morning, the afternoon. And then also see if we can bring a little freedom of movement in the body. So if you are slumped in your chair, let's go ahead and turn around. Let's slide over from the desk a little bit. Go ahead and bring your feet to the floor and sit upright, nice and tall, as though you were in a ladder back chair. We're gonna let the chin be parallel with the seat or possibly the floor. All right, from here, let's go ahead and start to move. Let's bring that right ear to the right shoulder. And then let's just go ahead and let the chin roll over. The left ear finds the left shoulder. One more time. Let's come on back. And get your hair in your face. Right? And then from here, we'll come on back up to center. And let's pretend we're in Arizona today, all right? We're gonna inhale the arms overhead, and then we're gonna open them to cactus arms. So we're gonna bring the shoulders and the elbows back towards each other and inhale up. And we're gonna do that three more times. So we're gonna open through the chest. Think about squeezing without tilting our pelvis really far forward. And we'll do that one more time. Following your own breath, gaze up towards the ceiling, the sky. Inhale the arms back up. We're gonna take a twist. So we're gonna bring that left arm to cactus and your right arm might come to your right thigh. If you have an arm on your chair, you might put your hand on the arm of your chair and bring the gaze to the right shoulder. And notice if you're pressing through your ribs. And if you are pressing them forward, draw the navel to the spine while keeping a free flow of breath. And let's bring that gaze now over to the left shoulder, but maintaining our twist. And let's inhale both arms up. And guess what? That's right, we're gonna do the opposite side. So check in. Again, you might choose to find your thigh with the left hand or perhaps the arm of your chair. Notice any tension in different areas of the body. Bring the gaze over to the right shoulder this time. We're gonna inhale both arms up. We're gonna exhale back to cactus arms. And we're gonna take a little tap. So we're gonna cross the right hand to the left thigh, left hand to right thigh. And we're gonna do that three more times for each side. So we are coming into contralateral movement, meaning we are crossing the body. So if today you need to do any critical thinking, any creative thinking, this is a great way to fire up both hemispheres of the brain. And one more time. And then we'll go ahead and release our hands. We'll root through all four corners of the feet, and then we're gonna stand up. I'm just kidding, we're gonna sit back down. And then we're gonna stand up. And then we're gonna sit back down. And now we're doing the cha-cha. No, we are not. We are not doing the cha-cha. We're gonna do this one more time. We're gonna land softly in the seat and we're gonna pop back up. And from here, we're maybe gonna gently slide our fingers down our waist to remind ourselves to be tall and long in the side body. And then from here, we're gonna march. So we're gonna pick up the right knee. And the left. That was the right twice, okay, so I would never have made it as a drill sergeant. All right, one more time. Release. Let's come back to those cactus arms. And now we're gonna cross the body again. One more time. And now we're doing the cha-cha. No, we're still not doing the cha-cha. This might be the Charleston, perhaps. All right. From here, let's go ahead and release. Take a breath. And from here, we're gonna come to a variation on cow face arms. So we're gonna bring that right hand up overhead, pat yourself on the back, letting your palm find the center of your back. This time, we're gonna bring the left hand onto the chest, and we're gonna breathe. Reminding ourselves to feel that breath in the back ribs, the front ribs. We want this right elbow to point towards the ceiling. You can always use your hand to press that up. And we want to breathe through our chest, our ribs, all the way into the belly. From here, we're going to go ahead and release. And we're going to change sides. So pat yourself on the back. Hey, you're doing great work today, right? Good job. Your boss would be proud. Maybe push that elbow up with the right hand. Bringing right hand into the heart. And we marched. Maybe you're like, hey, there's donuts in the break room. Now we want to slow ourselves down a little bit. So perhaps we lengthen the exhale. If you want to know why it's called cow face arms, leave me a note in the link below. I have two great stories. And then from here, we're gonna go ahead and release. Let's bring the mounds of the big toes together. We're gonna sit back for just a moment into your fierce pose. People call this chair. It's actually fierce or awkward, or as I like to call it, fiercely awkward pose. You may hold for as long as you like. And then we're gonna go ahead and release. And as you can see what a quick few minutes can do to help release some stress. From here, let's channel our inner child. What you doing? I know, what are you doing? Let's give it a little swing. And we'll go ahead and release that. Bringing awareness back to the breath. That is the end of our few minute practice. Now you're already standing, so if you want to continue to do something for you to give yourself a little release, if you're working from home, maybe go pet the dog, pet the cat, or maybe just go ahead and march yourself right into the kitchen and get a glass of water. Thank you for spending these few minutes with me. Namaste.